सचिन पुजेरी, सचिन पुजेरी, अभिनंदन।
सर
ओके, अभिषेक, अभिषेक, अक्षता।
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, आनंद,
यस
आनंद,
सर।
राइट,
यस सर।
ओके, अंजुम, अंजुम, बसराज गडकरी, बसराज गडकरी, बसवराज ऐनापुरे, बसवराज ऐनापुरे, भाग्यश्री, भाग्यश्री,
प्रेजेंट सर।
राइट,
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, भक्ति,
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, भारती,
प्रेजेंट सर।
राइट, चेतन कुमार, चेतन कुमार, दीपक, दीपक, दिव्या,
यस सर।
ओके, गणपत में शिवाजी, गणपत में शिवाजी, ज्योति,
यस सर।
राइट, किरण,
यस सर।
ओके, लक्ष्मीकांत, लक्ष्मीकांत, मांतेश,
यस सर।
राइट, मोले प्रेम, मोले प्रेम, नागेश, नागेश, नंदीश,
यस सर।
ओके, पूजा पाटिल,
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, प्रमोद कुमार, प्रमोद कुमार, प्रवीण मकदुम, प्रवीण, प्रियंका,
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, संध्या,
यस सर,
संध्या, राइट, राइट, संतोष पुजारी, संतोष पुजारी, संतोष सोनार, संतोष सोनार, शाहबाज,
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, शफिया,
प्रेजेंट सर।
राइट, श्रीधर सोलकनौर, श्रीधर सोलकनौर, सृष्टि, सृष्टि,
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, ओके, सिद्धार्थ,
प्रेजेंट सर।
बुर्नेकर, सिद्धार्थ पाटिल,
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, सिद्धार्थ पाटिल, सिद्धार्थ पाटिल, सुप्रिया,
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, वंदना,
प्रेजेंट,
राइट, वंदना, वंदना, वसंत,
यस सर।
ओके,
यस,
राइट, वीरदत्त, वीरदत्त, योगेश,
यस सर।
ओके, महेश दुड़मनी, महेश, बालेश, बालेश, तैक मोहम्मद,
यस सर।
राइट, प्रवीण राठौड़, यस सर। ओके, अभिषेक, अभिषेक,
यस सर।
ऐश्वर्या,
प्रेजेंट सर।
राइट, अमानुल्ला, अमानुल्ला, बंडोड़कर तनय मोहनदास, बंडोड़कर तनय मोहनदास, भावराव, भावराव, शोधन
सर।
ओके,
शोधन, प्रेजेंट, प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, देवणर अनिल कुमार शेख, देवणर अनिल कुमार शेखप्पा, नंद कुमार, नंद कुमार, प्रमोद, प्रमोद, रोहिणी, रोहिणी, ओके, रोहित अलवाणी, रोहित अलवाणी,
Present sir.
Right. Shashidhar.
Present sir.
Okay. Shashidhar. Gowdar. Shashidhar Gowdar.
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes sir.
Shridhar. Shridhar.
Yes sir. Present sir.
Right. Saish. Snehal. Snehal. Vaishnavi.
Present sir.
Okay. Karthik Yam. Karthik Yam. Right. Let's begin with the today's class students. Anybody turned up late? Anybody yet to give the attendance?
The Bhavan Kumar is present, sir.
Yes, sir. I'm marked yours. Anybody else?
Sir.
Pardon? Anybody else?
Hello,
sir. Shashidhar Gowdar, I have marked. Abhishek Palekar, I have marked. 54. Roll number? Rohini Pawli, I have marked. I have marked yours. Anybody else?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Is there
a order, sir? I have marked yours, sir. I have marked.
Okay. Sir, Shridhar also there?
Shridhar, I have marked yours. I have marked.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Let's begin with the class. Right. So students, we are discussing programming part in the last class. I had discussed the program to find the number of ones in a given byte. Let us move on to the second program. Assume that an ASCII character string is stored in the on-chip ROM program memory starting at address 200H. Write a program to bring each character into a CPU and send it to P1. They are asking to assume ASCII character string, some ASCII character string stored in the ROM memory starting at address 200H. That means you have to write a small program starting with the origin 200H, right? Where we are storing few characters, ASCII characters or the characters. And what we have to do, we have to write a program, that is assembly program, right? To bring each ASCII character, we have to bring it into a CPU. Bring it into a CPU means we have to store it in A register first. And then from A register, we have to send it to P1 or we have to move it to P1. So this is the program that we are supposed to write. So let us see how to write this program. So what they are asking? They are asking to store the ASCII characters first, starting at memory location 200H. Okay, so let us store the characters, ORG.
Sir, 100H. Sound some pidagat, sir.
ಸೊಬ್ರಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಈಗ ನಂದೀಶ್ ನಂದೀಶ್
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಸೇಮ್
ಸೌಂಡ್ ಕೇಸಾತಿಲ್ರಿ
ಕೇಳಸ್ತ ಸರ್ ಅದು ಎಕೋ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಎಕೋ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್
ಎಕೋ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಈಗ ನಂದೀಶ್ ಓಕೆ ಐತೇನ್ರಿ ನಂದೀಶ್
ಹಾ ಸರ್
ನಂದೀಶ್
ಹಾ ಸರ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಐತಿ
ಸೌಂಡ್ ಸರಿ ಐತ್ರಿ ಓಕೆ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು They have asked to store the ASCII characters first, so let us store the ASCII characters starting from the memory location 200. Store the first instruction of the first character, whatever we are supposed to store, ORG 200H. Then next will be, we are storing the character. So how to store the characters? We have to use the assembly director, assembler directive, that is define byte DB. Okay, this we have studied when we are studying the assembler directives. Define byte, if we have to use it to store all the characters. Now we can store the characters. So characters I'm going to store is like this. The earth is but one country, and mankind its citizens. Then I will last character, I will use it as a zero, that is null character, to come out of the characters. Last character is the null character. So I'm using the characters like this. So I have stored the characters like this. Define byte I have used. Okay, the define byte means it will store the characters in terms of byte. Okay, 1 byte characters, these are all. Okay, and these are all ASCII characters of 1 byte. Now storing means how it will store, it will not store it as T. It will store the ASCII value of T, right? Here suppose if you take this country, right, if you are storing N, it will not store it as N, it will store the ASCII value of N, character N, or the alphabet N. Okay, so while storing, it will store the ASCII value, but not the characters. Characters are not stored, it cannot store the characters. What it will store is the ASCII value of these characters will be stored in the memory location. Okay, that is starting from memory location 200H. What it indicates here, in 200H memory location, in 200H memory location, the first character, that is ASCII value of T, is stored. ASCII value of that is stored, suppose say ASCII value of T, say 35. Okay, 35H, that is stored in 200. Then in next memory location, 201H, the next value, that is ASCII character of H, is stored. Let us say it is 38H, like that. So these ASCII characters are stored starting from memory location 200H. That is what they have mentioned in the program. Then what they are asking is, they are asking to bring these ASCII characters into the CPU, that is into A register, and then send it to port P1 of the microcontroller 8051. Okay. Now we have to write a program for that. Let us start taking some starting memory location, ORG 100H. I am taking 100H, you can take 0000 also, 100H. Then here I have to use, as the memory location they have mentioned is 200H, it is of almost 16 bits, that is 12 bits. So it is more than 8 bits. Let us use a 16-bit register, store the memory location. I am using move DPTR, 16-bit register, move DPTR, comma, hash 200H. Move DPTR, comma, hash 200H, that is load the data pointer. Then, now next what I have to do is, I have to use the instruction. Which instruction I can use if I am using DPTR? And if it is a ROM memory, move code, MOVC. Okay, the instruction that is available to move the value from the ROM memory is this instruction, MOVC. MOVC, A comma at A plus DPTR, at A plus DPTR. This is the instruction that is available to move the data stored in the ROM memory into the A register. Okay, move code, this C stands for code or the ROM memory, right? Now using this instruction, we have to bring the character, ASCII character of these characters into the A register and then send it to port P1. So for that, what we will do is, first we will bring the character into A register. I am using the instruction clear A, so that if there is any dummy value, garbage value stored in A register, that will be cleared. So I'm using the instruction clear A instruction. Then next instruction, what I will do is MOVC, directly I will use the instruction MOVC A comma at A plus DPTR, at A plus DPTR, A plus DPTR, right? MOVC A comma at A plus DPTR. Then next instruction, from A I have to move it to port P1. Then before, after this instruction, it will check whether the character is null character, whether it is the last character. To check that, I have to use the instruction JZ to next. Jump if 0 to next. If the value in A register is 0, that is if it is this character, last character, null character, 0, then it will jump to next. And then it will end the program. Suppose if it is not the 0, if it is not 0, if it is not the null character, then what it should do if the condition fails? The condition fails here, then it has to move the value in A register into put P1. Move P1, comma A. Then once it is stored the first ASCII character of, that is set as, we have assumed it as 35, is it not? That is stored in A first, and from A it is moved to P1. From A it is moved to, and send it to P1. After storing it, we have to get the next ASCII character, that is of H, second alphabet ASCII character. To get that, what we have to do? We have to increment the DPTR. Now DPTR is 200H. Here DPTR is 200H initially. It's taking the first character. Then we have to get the next second ASCII character of the second alphabet. To get that, I will use the instruction increment DPTR. So that DPTR value will be, now the recent value will be, what is the latest present previous value? 200H. 200H, what is the increment instruction? It will add 1. 200H plus 1, this will be 201H. 201H. Okay, 201H. Increment DPTR means it will add 1 to the already stored value in DPTR. 200H is the previous value plus 1, it will be 201H. Next. So if it is 201H, then what next it has to do? It has to repeat the moving of the ASCII characters into A, then from A to P1. So to repeat that, I have to use the instruction, it is SJMP B1, then this loop should come here, the clear A instruction, to the clear A instruction, because from clear A, it has to repeat. Okay. Now clear A means what is happening here? A is equal to 0. A is equal to 0. Then move C A comma at A plus DPTR. That is A is equal to what is the value in A? 0. 0 is the value in A. 0 plus the value in DPTR. What is the value in DPTR? 200H. That is 0 plus 200H. This will be 200H. At 200H. What is the value in 200H? At 200H, the value is 35H. That is the ASCII character of the alphabet T. ASCII character of the alphabet T. Yes or no? That will be stored in A register. ASCII value that is stored in A register. So in A register, the value that will be stored is how much we have taken? We have assumed that is 35H in 200H. This value will be stored in A register. That is 35H. And jump if 0, is this a 0 value in A register? No, it is not 0. If it is 0, then it will jump to next. So where this next should come? Next is after this SJMP. After this SJMP, this I am writing next here. So that is the end of the program. It is the end of the program. Suppose if it is not 0, if the value in A here is 35, it is not 0, then what it has to do? It has to move that value into P1. It has to move that value into P1. P1 is equal to A, that is equal to 35H, that is equal to 35H. So we have moved the ASCII character of first alphabet into A, and then from A into P1. We have got it in P1 port. Port 1 value is 35H. Then to get the next memory location, we are incrementing DPTR, that is 200H plus 1, that is 201H, short jump to B1. This is called as unconditional jump. So this JZ, it is jump if zero, it is called as conditional jump. That is, if the condition is satisfied, only then it will jump to the target. Jump if zero, if the value in A is zero, then only it will jump to next. Otherwise, if condition fails, it will execute the next instruction. Correct? So these are such instructions, JZ next, JC, jump if carry, JNC, jump if no carry. They are all called as conditional jump instructions, which we'll be studying later. Okay, then this instruction, SJMP, this is called as unconditional jump instruction. Unconditional jump instruction. So it is without any condition, it will directly jump to this address, that is to the instruction clear A. Okay, so it is called as unconditional jump instructions. Fine. So this is how it will get the next memory location 201H. It will jump to B1, clear A. A is equal to 0 again. Then move C A comma at A plus DPTR. The value in A is 0 again because it is 0 here. We have cleared it. Then 0 plus recent value in DPTR. A plus DPTR. What is the recent value in DPTR? 201H. So it will be 0 plus 201H. 0 plus 201H. Which is nothing but 201H. So if it is 201H, value in 201H is how much? That is ASCII character of H. It is 38 we have assumed. 38 will be stored in A register. So in A register, 38 will be stored. 38H. Yes. So jump if 0 to next. If the value in A is 0, then it will jump to next. But as it is not 0, if condition fails here, it will execute the next instruction. Move P1, comma A. That is, move P1 is equal to A is equal to move P1 is equal to A is equal to how much? That is the value in A, which is 38x. It will increment DPTR 200H plus 1, previous value plus 1, this will be 202H. It is then executing SJMP B1, short jump to B1. It will come here, clear A. Then it will repeat the same instructions, which is a loop. So this B1 to B1, these instructions here is nothing but it is called as a loop. What is a loop? A loop is set of instructions which are executed more than one time. A loop consists of set of instructions which are executed more than one time. Okay. So this is called as a loop. Fine. Then once it finishes all the characters, the last character is null character, that is zero. When it comes to this particular memory location, say let us say it is at 223H memory location. So at 223H memory location, 0 is there. 0 will be stored in A register. 0 will be stored in A register. Use the instruction move C A, at A plus DPTR. Then it will check jump if 0. If it is 0, yes, it is 0. Value in A is 0. If it is 0, then it will jump to next. So when it executes next here, it will end the program. That is the end of the program. Okay, so this is how this program, this is an assembly language program. The same program is also there in C language for you all, okay, which you'll be studying later. Right now you are studying only the assembly language programs. Okay, so such programs may be asked in examination. Okay, so you all understood this program here? Yes, understood this program here? This program is clear? First, you have to write this. Okay, you have to store the characters first using ORG 200H. In 200H, they have mentioned store it using the assembler directive DB, define byte. Okay, so the ASCII characters of all these characters will be stored. Then come back and write the main program ORG starting from 100H. You can take any memory location, starting memory location. Move DPTR comma hash 200H. That is the starting memory location where these characters are stored. It is 200H. The first character T is stored in 200H memory location. So move DPTR comma hash 200H. Clear A, make the value in A 0 so that any garbage value is there in A, that will become 0. That will be cleared. Move C A comma at A plus DPTR. This is for moving the value from the ROM memory. Move code. A plus DPTR means A value is 0. 0 plus 200H. The value in 200H is 35. That will be stored in A register. It is not 0. If it is 0, then it will jump to next. So as it is not 0, the value in A will be moved into P1 using the instruction move P1 comma A. Then we have to get the Next ASCII character. To get that, we have to increment the memory location. Increment DPTR. 200H plus 1, it will be 201H. Short jump to B1. Jump back to B1 instruction. B1 instruction is clear A. Again, the value in A becomes 0. Next, and this time it will add value in A with 201H, because now the value is 201H here. DPTR value. The value in 201H memory location is how much? 38H. This will be stored in A register. Then from A register, if condition fails here, then it will be stored in B1 register. Again, it will increment DPTR. Next time it will be 201 plus 1, it is 202H. So like this, it will repeat until the last character, which is the null character that we have stored, that will become the end of the program. Okay. So is it understood here, students? This program is clear here? Yes? Is it understood? Abhinandan? Abhinandan?
Yes,
clear?
Yes,
program is clear? Okay. Divya?
Yes, sir.
Program is clear? Understood?
Yes, I understood.
Okay. Priyanka?
Sir, explain move P1 that line, sir.
Move P1, comma A. Move P1, comma A means the value in A register will be moved into P1. It is the move instruction, copy instruction. Value in A is how much? 35H, correct? The first value, the first ASCII character what we have taken here, it is 35H. It is in memory location 200H, the first character, ASCII character of T, right? That will be moved into P1. That will be copied into P1. That will be stored into P1 register. Move P1, comma A. That is, value in A is 35H. That will be stored in P1 register. Port P1 register. So you get the value P1 is equal to A is equal to 35H. Okay.
Sir, if similarly, it is 38H then, sir. Sir, if pardon? It is 38H. Sir, next time, how it will be stored in P1, sir?
Next time, yes. Correct. That's a good question. See here. Next time what it will do is it will execute move P1 comma A. So whatever the recent value you have got, that is 38, that will replace the older value. That will replace the older value. So older value will be erased. Okay, the older value will be erased and new value will be stored. New value will be stored in that port P1. Getting the point here, Siddharth?
Okay, sir. So then how that all that will be stored, sir?
Where?
Whole sentence.
No, it will not be stored as a whole, as a set. Whenever you are storing a new value, older value will be erased. So finally, what we want the port 1, it will go on storing here. Okay. Now, how to check this port P1? You have to do step-by-step execution. You cannot do at-stretch execution here. If you want to check the port P1, what all contents is getting moved into P1? Okay, it is P1 is not that it is a 8-bit register, is it not? P1 is a 8-bit register. It can store maximum 8 bits, right? If you are storing 35, that is the maximum. If you are storing 38, that is the maximum. Okay, you cannot store the value, say 235H. It becomes more than 8 bits, correct? Or you cannot store 0235 at a stretch. It is more than 8 bits. What you are doing is you are storing byte by byte. Okay, if you want to check this program how it is getting executed, you have to execute in step mode, stepwise execution mode. Stepwise execution means you have to check when this instruction is executed, what is the value you are getting. When this instruction gets executed, what is the value in DPTR? When this instruction executes, what is the value in A register? Then when this executes, where the microcontroller will jump or where it will go, right? When this executes, what is the recent value in P1? So like that, you have to go on checking every instruction step by step. It is not that just like as you press Control F9 in C language, directly you get the whole program executed at once. Here also you can do that. But for this particular program, you have to check every instruction step by step. Only then you will understand how the values are getting moved into port P1. Got the point, Siddharth?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir, for 202, we have not stored any value then?
If you have not stored any value, then it will take it as a null character by default. See, if you have not stored any character, means it is zero, right? Zero, default value is zero, correct? By default. So if you are not storing anything, it is a default value. It will come out of the program immediately. Got the point? Okay. Any other questions here? Understood, right? Shall we move to the next program?
Yes, okay. Sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Fine. Okay. This was the second program. Let us move to the third program. Write a program to copy the value 55H into RAM memory locations 40H to 45H using direct addressing mode, register indirect addressing mode without a loop and with a loop. It's a simple program. You have to just make use of move instructions here. Write a program to copy the value 55H into RAM memory locations 40H to 45H. That means you have to store the value 55H starting from memory location 40H to 45H. First, using direct addressing mode. Second, using register indirect addressing mode but without a loop. And third, using register indirect addressing mode with a loop. Okay. So these are the three set of instructions that we have to use. One is direct addressing mode, register indirect addressing mode without a loop, and register indirect addressing mode with a loop. Right. Let us write this. So what they have mentioned here, they have mentioned to copy the value 55H. Okay, it's a, we'll do that. So first one, what they are asking, using direct addressing mode. Okay, so let us use the instruction. First is direct addressing mode. Direct addressing part A. Part A is direct addressing mode. Direct addressing. What we will do is first we'll store the value in A register. Okay. You can store the value in A register. There is no harm in it. Move A comma. One value is how much? How much they have mentioned? 55H. Move A comma hash 55H. Move A comma hash 55H. Next, now can we use directly the addressing mode, that is direct addressing mode, to store this value 55H into the memory location 40H? Is it possible? Yes. Can you use the instruction move 40H comma A? Is it possible?
Yes, sir.
Of course. Yes, it is possible. Very good. It is possible. Let us use that move. The memory location they have mentioned is first one 40H, 40H comma A. That means with the first instruction, value in A is 55H, value in A is 55H. Then with the second instruction, the value in 40H will be how much? The value in A, the value in A is how much? 55H. So like this, the value 55H will be stored in 40H. That is the first memory location. Second, they are asking to store in consecutive memory location, that is 41H. Move 41H. You use direct addressing mode only. You cannot use any other addressing mode. Move 41H comma A. That means in 41H memory location, the value in A, that is 55H, will be copied or it will be stored. Similarly, move 42H, 42H comma A. Move 42H comma A. Right, this instruction moves the value into 42H. 42H is equal to value in A, that is 55H. 55H. And let us take the next memory location. Move 43H comma A. That means in 43H memory location, the value in A, that is 55H, will be stored. Next. Yes, 42, how much do I mention? 45H. Still two more memory locations are remaining. Move 34H, 44H comma A. That is in 44H, the value of A will come. That will be 55H. 55H. Next instruction, last one. Move 45H comma A, comma A. This will store in 45H memory location the value of A register, that is 55H. So the first part of the program is done. That is, using direct addressing mode, you are copying the value 55H into RAM locations 40H to 45H. Then let us go ahead with the second part of the program. This is simple, right? You all understood this? you have to make use of direct addressing mode. Move 40h comma a. This is direct addressing mode because you are using memory location in the instruction. Okay, this is direct addressing mode. Yes or no? Direct addressing mode. Using direct addressing mode, we have moved the value 45h. We have copied the value 55h. Starting from memory location 40h to 45h. Fine. Next. That is the second part of the program. Now we have to use indirect addressing mode. The second part they have mentioned to use indirect addressing. Indirect addressing, but without a loop. Without a loop. You should not make use of loop here. Without a loop. Without a loop. Now how to make use of indirect addressing without a loop? Now first instruction is same as that of a previous one. Let us move it in A register. Move A comma hash 55H, hash 55H. Now, if you want to make use of indirect addressing mode, what type of instructions you have to make use?
At.
Move A comma at R1.
Correct. Move A comma at R1. R1 means there it can be 0 or 1. Correct. R1 means R1 can be either R0 or R1. Yes or no? So what we will do is we'll take one pointer. We'll take one pointer to R0. Move R0. That will store the first memory location. First memory location is this, whatever they have given, 40H. We'll store that in R0. That is 40H. It is a pointer to 40H memory location. You know the meaning of pointer. Pointer is one which stores the memory location. Correct? You have studied it in C language. It stores the memory location. So move R0 comma hash 40H means the memory location 40H, that is the address of the memory location, is stored in R0 register. Then next, what we can use, now as you all told, we can use move A comma at R0, but we have to store it in R0, that is in 40H memory location. The instruction I have to reuse it in a reverse way, it is move at R0 comma A, because what I want is, I want to store this value 55H in 40H memory location. Where is this 40H memory location? It is stored in R0 register. When I use this instruction move at R0 comma A, that means the in R0 register in which there is a value 40H memory location, in 40H memory location, the value 55H of A register will be stored. Okay, this is indirect addressing mode. Next, what we have to think is, what we have to say is, we should not use loop here. Okay, we have to go on repeating the instructions. Now, using a loop means we are using the same instructions inside a loop. Now, if we are not using a loop, let us see what happens here. The number of instructions will increase. I will show you that first without a loop, then with the loop, then we'll compare without a loop with the one which we are doing using a loop here. Next instruction, I got it in R0, that is 40H in memory location, we have got 55H. To get the next memory location, what I have to do? I have to increment the R0 register. Increment R0. Okay. That means in R0, the value will be how much? 40H plus 1. That will be 41H. Again, I have to make use of this statement, that is MOV at R0 at R0 comma at R0 comma A. If I make use of this, now what will be the value in R0? Value in R0 is now 41H, the recent value. Okay, is 41H. In this 41H memory location, the value, that is how much will be stored? 41H, the value in A. Value in A is same, that is 55H only. That is not changing. It is 55H. Similarly, to get the next memory location, again use the increment instruction, increment R0. So it will be R0 is equal to 41H plus 1, that will be 42H. Then again use the instruction, same, move at R0 at R0 comma A. This will store in R0 register, we have 42H, and in 42H memory location, 55H value will be stored. Next, again increment to get the next memory location, next consecutive memory location. Increment R0, increment R0. So R0 will be equal to 42H plus 1, which will be 43H. Then again repeat the same instruction, move at R0, A. That is, in R0 register, there is memory location 43H stored, and in memory location 43H, the value 55H is copied or it is stored. Now I have finished in 43. Still, how many are remaining? 44 and 45. Again, increment. Increment R0. That means in R0, I will be storing 43H plus 1. Plus 1, that will be 44H. Then move at R0 at R0, comma A. Here in R0 register, we have 44H. And in 44H memory location, the value stored will be 55H. Last memory location, increment R0. R0 will be equal to previous value. Previous value is 44H. 44H plus 1. 44H plus 1. That will be 45H. Then move at R0. Or at R0, A. That is, in R0 register, the memory location is 45H, last memory location. In memory location 45H, the value we are storing is 55H. So see the number of instructions from here to here. Almost there are 10 to 12 instructions. Okay, this is without using loop register indirect addressing mode. Suppose if we use the loop, let us see the part C. This you all understood here. Just we have to make use of move statement, then move at R0, yes, A, and increment R0. Clear, right? Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then last one is using register indirect addressing mode. Indirect addressing mode. But we have to make use of loop with the loop statement. How to do it? The starting instructions will remain the same. Move A comma hash 55H. Move R0 comma hash 40H. Move at R0 comma A. They will remain the same. So let us write it down. Move A comma hash 55H. Move R0 comma hash 40H. Move at R0 comma A. Then once this is done, now, how many values are there from 40H to 45H? How many memory locations it is? 40H to 45H, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 6 memory locations. That means 6 values, correct? Whenever you are using the loop, you have to make use of the counter or the count. Okay, so just as you are using the functions, or you are using, say, a small sub program in C language, okay, where you are repeating, say, some few times, you are using a for loop, correct? So what that for loop does, it repeats for certain number of times. I value are incrementing, correct? So like that, here also, to repeat the number of operations, we are using the count. So that count we have to store in some of the register. So I will take R5 register. I cannot take R0 and R1. They are used for indirect addressing mode. In R5 register, I am storing the count, that is 06. Move R5 comma hash 06. Once I move the first value, move at R0 comma A, in 40H I am storing 55H. Next instruction will be to get the next memory location. So I will use increment R0, increment R0. Increment R0 means in R0 register, what will be the value? Recent value is now 40H. This is the recent value. R0 is equal to 40H. So increment means it will add 1 to the already existing value, previous value. It is 40H plus 1. This will be equal to 41H, right? Now we got the second memory location, right? Next, what we have to do is, we have to check whether the count is 0, whether this count has reached 0, That means whether our program has completed all the operations that is necessary. Now we are moving the value 55H starting from 40H to 45H, whether this is completed. How we are checking that? Every time when you are performing the move operation, when you are moving the value 55H from the 40H to, that is from 55H you are moving into 40H, when you are completing it, you are incrementing the memory location, then you have to check for the count. When you have moved the first value, still how many more values are remaining? DJ and Z. You have moved the first value, correct? First value is 55H, you have moved into first memory location, 40H. Still, how many memory locations are remaining or how many values are remaining still? 40 to 45.
Four.
How many are remaining?
Sir, five.
Five are remaining, correct. You are right. So, five are remaining because six is the count. We have moved the first value into first memory location. Still, five memory locations are remaining. So, we have to use the DJNZ instruction. DJNZ R5, comma, again. We have to repeat it. Again, we are using a loop here. Decrement the value in R5 register. Decrement the value in R5 register. R5 will be 06, recent value minus 1. Decrement means minus 1, increment means plus 1. This will be 05. So after decrementing, the value is not 0. If it is not 0, it will jump to again. So where this again should come? Move R5 comma hash 06. No, it should not come here. Again, it will be repeat of all the steps of all these six operations. So it has to come here. Okay. The again has to come here. You have to decide that also, where this again should come or where the back should come, where the instructions should start repeating. Okay. That you have to decide, you have to judge. Okay. And accordingly, you have to use that loop. So it has to come here. So that move at R0, comma A means in R0, recent memory location is 41H now. We have incremented the memory location. The value in 41H, in 41H memory location, we are storing the value 55H. Okay. Then again increment. Again increment. Next time it will be 41H plus 1. That will be 42H. 42H decrement R5. DJNZ. Decrement and jump if not 0. That is 5 minus 1. It will be 4. It will be 4. It is not 0. Value is not 0 after decrementing. After decrementing, you have to check. Okay, that you have to take care. After decrementing, check the value. If it is not 0, then it will jump. Otherwise, it will execute the next subsequent instruction. So after decrementing, the value is 4. It is not 0. It will jump to again. Move at R0, comma I. This time, the value is 42H in R0. In 42H, the value 55H will be stored. So this will go on repeating up till the last memory location. That is, in 45H memory location, the value 55H is stored. Once it is done, then this count, increment R0, it will be 45H plus 1, 46H. Decrement R5, the last value will be decrement 1 minus 1. That will become 0. So if it is not 0, only then it will jump again. As it is 0, it will not jump again. It will execute the next instruction. That is the end of the program. That is the end of the program. This is how we are using the loop. You can just see here, using the loops, how many instructions you have used? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hardly 7 instructions. But without the loop, how many instructions? There are around 12 instructions. Is it not? So this is the difference between using the loop and without using the loop. If you are using the loop, the number of instructions gets reduced and the efficiency of the program will also increase. Okay. The time taken to execute the program is also decreased. Right? So these are the advantages of using the loop over that of without using the loop statement. Clear here, students? So this program is understood here. How to move the value 55H using direct addressing mode from memory location 40H to 45H. How to move the value 55H using indirect addressing mode without a loop. That is, use the instruction increment R0 and every time repeat move at R0, comma A. Then without the with the loop, using indirect addressing mode, use the same instructions, move a comma hash 55h, move r0 comma hash 50h, use the count here. That is one more instruction that will get added. If you are using a loop, the count will come into picture. The count will come as an instruction here, right? And then we are repeating. We are using the instructions we use with inside the loop. Inside this loop, we are repeating the same set of instructions. Okay. then once all instructions are done, one all the operation is completed, required our program is completed, then it has to come out of the loop and then it will execute the end instruction to stop the program. Is it clear here, students? Understood? This program is understood here?
Yes, sir.
Alwani?
Yes, sir.
Rohit? Rohit, is it understood? Alwani? Gowdar? Gowdar? Understood the program? Gowdar? Gowdar? Rohini? Rohini? Is it understood? Paule? Shabaz?
Yes, sir. I understood, sir.
Understood? Okay. Shafia? Shafia?
Sir, understood, sir.
Okay. Mantesh?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Understood. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Anand Kyabani? Akshata? Akshata? Is it understood?
Sir, that last step, sir, when you use the again, that I didn't get.
Yes, I will explain that quickly. See here, DJNZ R5, comma again. Okay. So this instruction is decrement and jump if not zero. Decrement and jump if not zero. Decrement means you have to subtract one. Okay. Now first value is 6 you have used. Okay, according to our count, we have used 6. Subtract 1 from this. 6 minus 1, it will be 5. Is it not? So after decrementing, if this value after decrementing is not 0, 5 is it 0? No. 5 is not 0. Correct? So if it is not 0, then we have to, or the instruction will jump to again. The microcontroller will jump to again. So where this again should come? It should come to this instruction. Move at R0, comma A. So the microcontroller will jump from this last instruction to this instruction in between. That is to instruction move at R0, comma A. Okay. So where you are putting this again, that you have to judge, that you have to decide whether you are putting here. If you put it here to the instruction move R5, comma hash 06, every time it will get loaded as 6. So the count will remain as 6. You are not at all completing your program. Every time you repeat it, it will get stored as 6. Okay, you're decrementing the count, it will become 5, then afterwards it will come to again R5 will be 6. You're decrementing the count, again it will be 6. So it is a never end program, it will go into infinite loop. It will go into infinite loop. That is why you have to decide where to put this again also. You have to judge it and thoughtfully, you have to think, and then you have to use this loop statement. Clear here, Akshata?
Okay. Yes, sir, I got it.
Fine. Anybody else wants to ask anything? Anybody else wants to ask anything? Jyoti, is it clear? Jyoti? Okay. So in the next class, we'll take up few more programs. That is a few of the assignment questions we'll take up. Okay. In the next two classes, we will take up few of the questions and we will try to, discuss. Okay. We'll discuss few of the things related to your assignment and a few of the programs if they are unsolved. Then we will discuss them in the next two classes. Okay. Anything else you want to ask? Okay. Then we'll end our class here. We'll begin in the, we'll take up the next things in the, yes, please.
Sir, can we submit it on Saturday, sir?
Yes, yes. Okay. No problem. Can submit it on Saturday. Okay. Fine.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you then.